Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the prayer session this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us pray. Thank you, Father, for giving us another time slot to pray, to come before the altar of prayer. We thank you, Father, for the energy to pray. Thank you for the alertness, for the diligence that you've given us, oh God, that we are coming into your presence to pray in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. Lord, we love, oh God, how amiable are your tabernacle. How lovely, oh God, are your dwelling places. Oh Father, we yearn to be in your presence, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh Father, we long to be in your presence, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, how beautiful are your dwelling places, oh God. Father, we thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that, Lord, you are drawing us closer to you, oh God, by the blood of Jesus, oh Father. We thank you, oh Father, that you cleanse us with the blood of Jesus, to come closer to you, our Holy Father. Yes, you are a holy God and you are a righteous God. Father, we know that in you there is no defilements. In you, Lord, there is no unholiness. In you, God, there is no pollution. There is no contamination. There is no poisons. But Lord, still the blood of Jesus washes us. Yes, from all the pollutions and all the poisons of the enemy. The blood of Jesus cleanses us, oh God, from the filth of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your love, oh God, that your love is pulling us closer to you, oh God. And you wash us clean, oh God. You wash us clean with the blood of the Lamb. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you for your care. Thank you, Father, for your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness upon our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Father. Thank you, Lord, that you give us confidence to approach you with no condemnation, with no fear, because the blood of Jesus is speaking for us. The blood of Jesus speaking forgiveness. The blood of Jesus is speaking grace. The blood of the Lamb is speaking on our behalf. We thank you, Lord, for that sacrificial blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. We praise you, worship you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. And we dedicate our lives to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We give you our will, our emotions. We give you, oh God, everything, our bodies. Yes, everything, we dedicate them before you, Lord. We bring our bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable before you, which is our reasonable and intelligent service before you. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father. Thank you, O Father, that you loved us with an everlasting love. Thank you, Father, that the love of God has been shed abroad upon our lives by the Holy Spirit. We thank you for the Holy Ghost, the Master Mentor, our teacher and our guide, our advocate, Spirit of Christ and Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, the Spirit of an endless life. We thank you, Father, for that spirit of the Zoe kind of love, the love of God. We praise you, O Father, in the name of Jesus, O God. Thank you, O Father, for covering us with your feathers. Thank you, Father, that you are our bulwark. You are our hiding place. You are our strong tower. Lord, we thank you, Father, that we run into your name and we are safe in your name, O God. That your name is a strong and mighty tower. We, the righteous, we run into it and we are safe. We are safe in the name of Yahweh. We are safe in the name of Jehovah El Shaddai. We are safe in the name of Jehovah Nissi, the banner of our victory, the one who causes us to triumph all the time. We thank you, Father, that we are safe in the name of Jehovah El Elyon, the Most High God, and that we are dwelling under the shadow of the Almighty God, Jehovah El Shaddai. We remain stable and confident, yes, unshakable, steady and unshakable, O God, under the wings of the Almighty God. Yes, Jehovah El Shaddai, the one who possesses all the power and all the authority, and whose power and authority no witch, no wizard, no power, no idol from the village, no serpentine spirit, no marine power can withstand your power. We thank you, Father, that there is no nanga, no sangoma, no sorcerer, no occultic power can withstand your power. We thank you, Father, that there is not even any covenant that can withstand your power, the power in the blood of Jesus, the power in the name of Jesus, the power, oh God, yes, of the fire of the Holy Spirit that you have given us, oh God. Thank you for the authorization to use your name. Thank you for the authorization that you have given us to use the blood of Jesus to fight our battles and to take our territory, to regain the lost territories and the lost properties in our lives. Father, we thank you, O God, for the victory that is guaranteed. You have given us and you have already fought our battles, and we are enforcing, yes, the defeat of the enemy through the name of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for equipping our lives, O God. Thank you for your people who are coming right here, Lord. Thank you, Father, for their lives, their families. They are all covered by the blood of Jesus, protected by the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for their destinies, that you have got colorful destinies for them in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, and we take authority over any power, any foul spirit that wants to hinder our prayer this morning. We overcome you by the blood of Jesus, and we command every agenda of the enemy to turn upside down. Let the agenda of the enemy turn upside down concerning our prayer this morning, concerning the destinies of the people who are coming on this prayer altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father, for your good news. We receive your word, O God. We receive your good news, Lord. Thank you, Father. We worship your name and we reject the suggestions of the enemy. We reject the whisperings or even the shoutings of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. We reject the lies of the devil. We are more than conquerors through Christ Jesus. We more than conquerors. And we know that God, yes, makes a way where there seems to be no way. We thank you, Father, for causing us to walk into the way that you have made where the enemy was saying there was no way. Thank you, Father, for the power for us to possess that which the enemy was saying we could not possess. Thank you for the power to go where the enemy was saying we cannot go there. Thank you, Father, for removing the barriers and the embargoes and the limitations against our lives, which the enemy had imposed upon our lives. We thank you for total victory in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Father. We declare our victory. We lift up the banner of our victory through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of satanic strongholds. And that satanic strongholds are going down by fire in the name of Jesus. Yes, every structure of the enemy, any satanic structures, any strongholds of the enemy against our lives, against our marriages, against our careers, against our businesses, against our colorful destinies, they are all coming down by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, we worship your name, Father, for victory. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit continue to burn. Let the bonfire of the Holy Ghost start to burn right now, even as we hand over our battles to the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Jehovah El Sabaoth. We thank you, Yeshua. We thank you, Emmanuel. We thank you, Adonai, in the mighty name of Jesus. All the glory and the honor be unto you this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Hallelujah. You're welcome to the prayer session in the name of Jesus. It's fantastic to see you all coming from everywhere, coming to pray. And the Lord whom we are calling upon is not going to let you down. He's never going to leave you alone. He's not going to put you to shame. Yes, we might have suffered shame. We might have been let down before by people. People are people. Hallelujah. But God is God. He is watching over his word to perform it in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, he will never leave you nor forsake you. He will be with you when you pass through whatever you pass through. Right now, maybe your situation is not pretty, but God is coming and he is going to take you out of that situation in the mighty name of Jesus. Keep on lifting your eyes to the Lord. Keep on firing the prayer, the fire prayer. Keep on walking in righteousness and in holiness. The Lord will never put you to shame in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is God. And he is not a man that he should lie. He is not a son of man that he should backslide, promise, and then break the promise. No, in the name of Jesus, he is a faithful God. He says, my covenant shall I not break, nor alter the things that have come out of my mouth. I'm watching over my word to perform it. And as the rain comes upon the earth, right? So the word of the Lord is sure to produce results and positive results. Hallelujah. 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 And the Lord's voice is the word. It's not going to return to him void in the name of Jesus. So in this prayer group, in this fire prayer group, we believe in the raw power of God. We believe that when we align ourselves through the blood of Jesus properly and come to the side of God and we pray the fire prayer, an effectual fervent prayer, which causes a lot of power to be available, right? We believe that God will change any situation in our lives. That the scriptures which Jesus was saying, things might be impossible. It might be impossible with men, but with God, all things are possible. We believe that word in the name of Jesus. We believe that scripture, that all things are possible. Say all things are possible in the name of Jesus. That all things are possible. It doesn't matter what it is. That any sickness, it can be healed. That cancer can be healed. That cancer, we command it to die, and then it goes back to hell where it came from. In the name of Jesus, the noisome pestilence will leave you alone. It will leave your loved ones alone as we fire the prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus. Doesn't matter the situation, whether it's financial, marriage, or whatever it is, the Lord God loves you and he wants to show off in your life. God wants to show off, yes, in front of the enemy. He wants to show off and he's looking for you. He's looking just for you to believe in him. And then he comes and shows off. Like how he showed off with that young boy, with David. Hallelujah. Showing off. Hallelujah. In front of the army of the Philistines, the giant was knocked down by a small boy. Hallelujah. God showing off. And what David did was just to choose to believe. That I choose to believe the Lord. I choose to believe the Lord that this man cannot defy the armies of the living God. Right? And then he chose to believe it. To believe God. That God, all things are possible with you. God, there is nothing impossible with you. God, you are with me. I'm not alone. God, the Almighty God, the one who has all the power, you are with me. I'm not alone. Therefore, this situation is going. Therefore, this giant is dying today. He has just written his funeral, his death certificate. He's just signed his death certificate, right? By defying the armies of the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So David chose to believe the Lord. Say, I choose to believe the Lord. Say, I choose to believe the Lord. There is nothing impossible with our God, ladies and gentlemen. Hallelujah. The same God who was working and who moved with David, he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It doesn't change. He is the unchangeable changer. God is in your life. Jesus is in your life. If you are not sure about your salvation, we'll help each other before we go far. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So believe the Lord and have confidence in the Lord. That God, yes, I don't see him, but he is with me. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6, we read that it is impossible to please God without faith. That anyone who comes to the Lord must necessarily believe that God exists and that he rewards those who diligently seek him. Hallelujah. So part of the diligence in seeking the Lord is to come and pray whilst others are snoring right now. Right. Right. A carnal person cannot understand why they should pray at this minute. They say, now, okay, fine, let me not go that, let me not swerve. Right. So you believe the Lord that God is with you and that he exists in your situation. He is right there. He is existing in your situation, in with you, in your room, wherever you are. That God is with you. The Almighty God, the creator of the sun and the moon and the stars, the creator of the galaxies, the Milky Ways, the great oceans, the great mountains, the things visible and invisible, he is with you. And that this God, he wants to talk to you personally, to have a personal conversation with you. Hallelujah. That's the beautiful part about this. It fires me up. That God, though he be high, but he has taken pleasure in the lowly. That when we humble ourselves before the mighty hand of God, that in due season he will lift us up. And that God resists the proud. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The proud do not pray to God. A proud person cannot pray to God. A proud person cannot pray to God. The proud person wants to crown themselves as God. That when they meet any situation, they can handle it with their money. That they can handle it with their intellect. They can outwit the problem. They can just sort the problems of life with their capacity, with what they have in their hands. That's a proud person. A proud person is saying, when the enemy comes in like a flood, I will raise up my standard against him, against the enemy. That's a proud person. And that pride is coming from the devil. And we know that the devil is up to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And that there is no one who can crown themselves as God and go anywhere. That they are just going down like Goliath. Hallelujah. God resists the proud. Right. Anyway, that was, by the way, hallelujah. Say thank you, Jesus. We're going to look at removing some evil odor from our lives this evening in the mighty name of Jesus. That the enemy can program an evil odor in the spirit. An evil odor upon someone, upon a lady, upon a gentleman, upon a man, upon a woman. And then the person now moves in rejection. That when this evil odor is not removed by the blood of Jesus, is not washed away, this canker is not removed by the blood of Jesus, then the person will face rejection wherever they go. Hallelujah. Let me read some scriptures and then we see. In Esther chapter 2, verse 17. And the king loved Esther above all the women, and she obtained grace and favor in his sight more than all the virgins, so that he set the royal crown upon her head and made a queen instead of Vashti. Hallelujah. Right? I'm sure you know the story of Esther. Right? Right? I want to believe that you know it. But what happened was that Esther... Anyway, you can read it. You can read. We don't have time. Right. You can read Esther chapter 2, verse 17. But read the whole chapter anyway, the whole chapters. And it's a good read. It's a fantastic story. Right. Hallelujah. Right. So Esther got favor. And she obtained grace and favor in the sight of the king. And she was loved more than all the virgins. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And she received a royal crown upon her head. And she was made the queen. That's favor. That's good smell. That is empowerment to prosper. That's a blessing. That God wants us to excel all the time. That God wants us to be favored all the time. God wants us to have the crown upon our heads all the time. A royal diadem to be upon our lives, that we may be the planting of the Lord, that instead of the spirit of heaviness, but we have the praise of the Lord. We are praising the Lord. Our mouths, our hearts are worshiping God. We are glorifying God all the time. And then now the spirit of heaviness leaves us. And then we are going. And the presence of the Lord is generated right there. Say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Esther found favor. That's a good smell. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Therefore, having these promises, beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit, and perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Hallelujah. Right. So there is what is called filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit. The flesh is defiled by sin. The spirit is defiled also by sin. And it can be programmed also. The spirit can be programmed to be filthy, to have a smell, an evil odor, a bad stench, a bad smell. Right? The enemy can manipulate. This is why the Bible says, suffer not a witch to live. Why? Because the witch has got power to get into the spirit and start to do anything they want to do. They can go and start to check the star of a person to see, because the blueprint of someone's destiny is in the star. And they can get in there, start to read there and say, okay, well, this is going to be a great person. And then see, what are we going to do about it? Let us steal the star. Let us cover the star. Let us rubbish the star. This is going to be a headache to us if we allow this person to flourish and to go on. We are going to lose our sleep. So let us rubbish, let us trouble this person. You know what I'm talking about. When Jesus was born, there were some people who decoded and they looked into the star of Jesus, and they could see that this star is a star of a king. And you know that they were called Magi. And if you check the meaning of Magi, M-A-G-I, you know that you will find out that it means sorcerer. Hallelujah. 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 And if you check also what happened to Moses, Moses' star was decoded. Pharaoh had all sorts of things around him. He had sorcerers, he had stargazers, he had soothsayers, he had magicians, he had everything he wanted. And they decoded the star of Moses and they said, there is a star coming here and the people are going to be free and we are going to lose our labor, our cheap labor, free labor. These slaves are going to go. And then they started to imagine vain things. They didn't have accurate info, but they had some idea. And they said, no, these people, they might rebel against us one day. So what are we going to do? Let us kill all the boys, all the male children that are born by the Hebrews. Let's kill them. Let's massacre them. So that, you see, we keep the population under control. The population of the male. Hallelujah. And then they started to kill the children. But because the star of Moses was too much, they couldn't touch it. They couldn't do anything about it. God had decided to redeem his people. God had decided to deliver his people from bondage. God had decided to deliver his people from the hand of Pharaoh. Hallelujah. Though Pharaoh was a formidable enemy, he lost the battle. He lost it. Because God had decided to deliver his people. And Moses, we know the story of Moses. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So the witch has to be destroyed. These, all the problems that we are facing, ladies and gentlemen, it's coming from witchcraft. Hallelujah. It's coming from witchcraft. Who is the biggest witch? The source of witchcraft is the devil himself. Then he comes with all sorts of friends. He comes like soothsayers, magicians. He comes like sorcerers. He comes like marine power. He comes like strong men from the village, the python spirit, the serpentine spirit, scorpion, everything and everything. He coming like that. The things that are troubling people, it's the powering source, the powering, what is it called? The power base of all that is witchcraft. So now, we are confronting this head on, ladies and gentlemen, and we are not afraid. We are not afraid at all. The Philistines, they're worshipping their Dagon. It's a witchcraft power. Yeah, hallelujah. Say thank you, Jesus. So there is a defilement that can happen to the spirit and to the flesh, right? So the enemy causes people to move in the flesh so that they can be defiled, right? So, and they can also program if this odor, evil odor in the spirit so that someone is rejected. Someone wants to get married, and they get, they're beautiful and everything is beautiful. But you and I, we know that there are some things that have been programmed against certain people from the village. That certain ladies cannot be married. Things have been programmed in the spirit realm, wherever they are, wherever, no one will say hello, no one will say anything to them, despite their beauty, despite the makeup, despite the handsomeness of the young men, despite the career, despite what they have, whether they are driving a good car, living in a good house or what, despite, but there's a program that has been programmed in the spirit realm that is affecting the person, and it's manifesting in this physical. No suitor, no nothing comes close, right? If someone gets married, the marriage, these powers, they make sure that the marriage is destroyed. They make sure that nothing comes out from there, and it's stealing, killing, and destroying. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. Ye that we might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of the water by the word. That when we are listening to the word of God, we are being washed. Actually, Jesus said, you are clean by the words that I have spoken to you. Hallelujah. Telling his disciples, you are clean by the words that I am speaking to you. And here he's saying, by the washing of the word. The word of God washes. It renews our minds. It washes us. Hallelujah. And from all defilements, from all pollutions. Leviticus chapter 18, 24 to 25. Do not defile yourselves with any of these things. For by all these, the nations are defiled, which I am casting out before you. For the land is defiled. Therefore, I visit the punishment of its iniquity upon it, and the land vomits out its inhabitants. Right, so there is defilement of the land, defilement of a person. It's defiled. Once something is defiled in the spirit, right? When someone is defiled, actually, when a Christian is defiled in the spirit, this is why we pray. Say, let the blood of Jesus wash me clean. Let me be washed from inside out. Every day, every time we pray that prayer. Why? Because the enemy is busy trying to smear, trying to throw mud, trying to throw some filth upon someone, so that when they go stand and pray, their prayers will be hindered. It's like trying to present some delicious food in some dirty plates. Hallelujah. So defilement hinders someone. It causes rejection before God. It causes also rejection elsewhere. When someone wants to get in through some business deals or even career, go to an interview or what, it causes all sorts of problems. Rejection, rejection, rejection. Psalms 51 verse 5. Behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin my mother conceived me. Right. So the sins of the parents can affect someone, and we know it. Right, Adam. John chapter 13, verse 6 to 10. Then he came to Simon Peter, and Peter said to him, "Lord, you are washing my feet." Jesus answered, said to him, "What I am doing to you, you do not understand now, but you will know after this." Peter said to him, "You shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "If I do not wash you, you have no part with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Then Jesus said to him, "He who is bathed needs only to wash his feet, but is completely clean, and you are clean, but not all of you." Hallelujah. So Jesus is cleaning the feet of his disciples. And he said, "What I'm doing, you have to do it also." Right? Just removing the dust, removing the dirt, to make sure that someone is clean, as a symbol of cleanliness in the spirit realm. Hallelujah. Right? We are going to pray in a few minutes. In Romans chapter 12, verses 1 to 2, "I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as living sacrifices, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God." Hallelujah. Say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. There is a conformity of this to this world that will cause defilements. That when we are moving in the counsel of the ungodly, we are defiled. When we walk in the paths of sinners, we are defiled. When we sit down to relax and rest where the scornful and mockers relax and sit, we are defiled. Hallelujah. But then now, when we delight ourselves in the word of the Lord, in the law of the Lord, and meditate upon it day and night, then we are making ourselves clean. Hallelujah. We are being cleansed by the washing of the word of God. We are being cleansed by the word that Jesus is speaking to us, which the word of God is speaking to us. Say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll read the last scripture. It's better we hold the scripture in the name of Jesus. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. "Do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers." That's another avenue which the enemy is using to defile people. "Do not be yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship is righteousness with lawlessness?" Lawlessness. Right? Righteousness is to follow the law, to follow what God says, to follow the light. But there is some lawlessness that people don't even care about anyone, about anything, about what is good. Right? And what communication is light with darkness? And what accord is Christ with Belial or Baal? Or what part is a believer with an unbeliever? And what agreement is the temple of God with idols? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. "For you are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I'll dwell in them, I'll walk with them, I'll be their God, and they shall be my people. Therefore, come out from among them and be ye separate, says the Lord. Do not touch what is unclean." Hallelujah. "And I will receive you." Say thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And we are told by James to draw near to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So defilements now, right? It hinders our prayers. It causes all sorts of rejections and frustrations and disappointments in our lives. So now we need to pray the prayer to remove any form of defilements in our lives, in our flesh, defilements of the spirit. As we have read that there is defilement of the spirit in 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1, that "Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit, and perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Say thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So the filthiness and the pollution, the contamination of the flesh and of the spirit can be dealt with the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus cleanses our spirits, cleanses our minds. That a mind that is perverse, a perverted mind, that is thinking wrong things upside down, thinking filthy. Okay, right. Shall I use it? Okay, maybe. Let me not use that word. It might be too heavy. Okay, right. So, but our minds can be cleansed by the blood of Jesus. We have to accept Jesus. First of all, to say, Jesus, come into my heart. Make me a child of God. Right now, if you're not sure of your own salvation, you're not sure where you stand, let us help one another. Let us make sure that we are on the correct side of Jesus. Where Jesus is, we want to be on the right side, where God is, so that when we fire the prayer, nothing is going to hinder. We want to be on the side of Jesus by accepting the cleansing power in his blood, so that every filth, every defilement, any poisons in our minds, any poisons in our souls, our spirits, and our bodies, and any contaminations, any defilements may be removed by the blood of Jesus. Pray after me if you want to make sure that you are saved. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, come into my heart right now. Lord Jesus Christ, I know I'm a sinner and I cannot save myself. Lord Jesus Christ, cleanse me from any defilements. Cleanse me from any pollutions. Cleanse me from any contaminations. Lord Jesus Christ, wash me clean with your blood. You died for me on the cross. You shed your blood on the cross of Calvary. So wash me clean. I believe you that you are my savior. I believe you that you are my savior. You are my master. Lord Jesus Christ, come into my heart. Make me a child of God. I reject all my sins now. I'm moving in holiness and in righteousness from this moment forward in the name of Jesus. Say, you Satan and your demons, get out of my life now. You Satan and your filth, get out of my life now in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, I don't belong to you anymore. I belong to Jesus. Jesus Christ is my savior. Jesus Christ is my master from this moment forward. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. 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 Say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I've got some more notes, but we're going to skip all that. Say, Holy Ghost fire, purge my spirit, purge my soul, purge my body from every pollution and any defilements in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Holy Ghost fire, purge my soul, my spirit, and my body from any evil odor in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Holy Spirit, cleanse me with your fire from every evil smell of rejection, every evil smell of disappointment, every evil smell of failure at the edge of breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Holy Ghost fire, yes, purge my soul, my spirit, and my body. Holy Ghost fire, purge my soul, my spirit, and my body from any defilements, from the food that I ate in my dreams. Yes, from any defilements that I got from the marine powers, and any defilements that I got from my girlfriend, any defilements that I got from my boyfriend, in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, purge my soul, purge my spirit, purge my body from any poisons, from any contaminations, in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, every evil door of pollution that the enemy is using to enter into my life to pollute me, let it be closed by the blood of Jesus. every satanic door through which the enemy is using to enter into my life, to pollute me, to poison my life, to contaminate me, to defile me, let it be closed now by the blood of Jesus. Say every door that the enemy is using to enter into my life, to pollute me, to contaminate me, yes, I command it to be closed by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, say every satanic door, every witchcraft door that the enemy is using to introduce evil odor, evil smell in my life, let it be closed by the blood of Jesus. Let it be closed by the blood of Jesus. Every door that has been used by the enemy, yes, to contaminate me, to pollute me, I command it to be shut by the blood of Jesus. Be closed now forever by the blood of Jesus. Be closed now forever by the blood of Jesus. Say every plantation of defilement in my body, come out now with all your roots. Every plantation of defilements in my body, come out now with all your roots. Every plantation of defilements in my body, come out now with all your roots. Come out now with all your roots. In the name of Jesus, say every plantation of defilements in my body, come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. Every plantation of defilements, of pollution, of poisons, of defilements in my body, come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, say any marine power polluting my body, polluting my soul, polluting my spirit, come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, say every marine power, every satanic power that is polluting my life, I command you to come out of my body now. In the name of Jesus, say every dark power, every evil personality living in my body to pollute me, to cause evil odor in my life, to cause rejections in my life, to cause disappointments in my life, come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, say every plantation of defilements in my body, I command you to come out now with all your roots. Come out now by fire. Come out now by fire. In the name of Jesus, say blood of Jesus, sanitize my body, sanitize my soul, sanitize my spirit. In the name of Jesus, blood of Jesus, sanitize my body, sanitize my soul, sanitize my spirit. In the name of Jesus, say blood of Jesus, sanitize my life, sanitize my body, sanitize my soul, sanitize my spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, say every weapon of witchcraft assigned to pollute my life, be destroyed by fire. Every weapon of witchcraft assigned to pollute my life, be destroyed by fire. Every weapon of witchcraft assigned to pollute my life, be destroyed by fire. Be destroyed by fire. Be destroyed by fire. Be destroyed by fire. Say any agent of darkness that has been assigned to pollute my life, to poison my life, to contaminate my life, to defile my life, I command you to catch fire and burn to ashes. Catch fire and burn to ashes. Say, agent of darkness, yes, that has been assigned to pollute my life, to cause evil odor, to cause evil smell in the spirit, in my spirit, in my body, in my soul, in my life, I command you to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Any satanic power, any witchcraft power, any dark power that has been programmed in my life to cause evil odor, to cause evil smell in my life, I command you to die by fire. I command you to die by fire. I command you to die by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, say thunder of God, strike all evil eyes monitoring my life. Thunder of God, strike all evil eyes monitoring my life. thunder of God, strike all evil eyes monitoring my life. Thunder of God, strike all evil eyes monitoring my life for pollution, for defilements, for poisons. In the name of Jesus, say every evil eye that is monitoring my life in order to pollute me, in order to pollute and poison my life, I command you to be blinded by fire. Be blinded now 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 by fire. Say satanic eyes monitoring my life for defilements, for pollutions, for contaminations. I command you to be blinded by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, say I shake off every evil deposit into my body. Yes, in the name of Jesus, say satanic deposits, witchcraft deposits, causing evil odor in my body from unfriendly friends. I shake you off. I shake you off by the blood of Jesus. I shake you off by the name of Jesus. I shake you off by the blood of Jesus. I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Say every evil deposits causing evil odor in my life, I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Say anything that has been programmed and deposited in my soul, in my spirit, in my body to cause evil smell, to cause evil odor in my life, I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Be neutralized now by the blood of Jesus. Be neutralized now by the blood of Jesus. Say any witchcraft deposits in my body to cause evil odor, to cause rejection, to cause disappointments, to cause failure at the edge of breakthrough, to cause frustrations in my life, I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Say any deposits of Satan in my body, in my soul, in my spirit, to cause evil odor of rejection, to cause evil odor of failure at the edge of breakthrough, to cause evil odor in my marriage, I command you to be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. Be neutralized by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say, blood of Jesus, go deep into the roots, into my roots. Blood of Jesus, go deep into my roots and uproot the source of every pollution in my foundation. In the mighty name of Jesus, blood of Jesus, go into my roots and uproot the source of every pollution in my foundations. In the mighty name of Jesus, say every source of pollution in my foundations catch fire and burn to ashes. Say every source of pollution in my foundations catch fire and burn to ashes. Every source of pollution in my foundation catch fire and burn to ashes. Catch fire and burn to ashes. Catch fire and burn to ashes. In the mighty name of Jesus, say blood of Jesus, flush out every poison it deposited in my life. Say every man, any woman circulating my name for evil, be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. Any man, any woman circulating my name for evil, be arrested by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Be arrested by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Any man, any woman circulating my name, circulating the name of my family, circulating the names of my children for evil, I command you to catch fire. Be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. Be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, any man, any woman, any boy, any girl, circulating my name, circulating the names of my children, circulating the names of my family. Yes, the name of my family for evil. I command you to be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. Be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. Be arrested by the fire of the Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say, I use the fire of God. I use the blood of Jesus to purge and destroy any pollutions of evil odor in my life. In the name of Jesus, say, I use the fire of God. I use the fire of the Holy Ghost. I use the blood of Jesus. I use the name of Jesus to purge out and destroy any evil odor in my life. Yes, in the name of Jesus, say, any evil odor in my life, disappear by fire. Any evil odor in my soul, in my spirit, in my body, disappear by fire. Disappear by fire. In the name of Jesus, say, every spirit of the skunk programmed against my life, I command you to disappear by fire. Disappear by fire. Every spirit of a smelly animal that has been programmed in my soul, in my spirit, in my body, I command you to catch fire and burn to ashes. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us put our hands on our heads. Say, I decree in my heart. I confess with my mouth. Divine favor upon me, divine progress in my life, divine blessings in my life, in the name of Jesus. I decree in my heart, I confess with my mouth that I am the head, I'm not the tail, I'm on top, I'm not below, I'm above, I'm not beneath. In the name of Jesus, I decree in my heart, I confess with my mouth, I receive divine connection. I receive divine perfume. I receive divine perfume. I receive Holy Ghost perfume. I receive divine favor. I receive divine blessings. I receive divine connections. I receive divine restoration. I receive divine promotion. I receive divine progress. I receive divine ideas. I receive divine attraction. I receive divine beauty in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree in my heart, I confess with my mouth that I am healthy, abundantly healthy. I am rich, abundantly rich. I am successful, abundantly successful. I am beautiful, abundantly beautiful. In the mighty name of Jesus, say, I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover my family with the blood of Jesus. I cover my soul, my spirit, my body with the blood of Jesus. I cover everything that concerns me with the blood of Jesus. Say, every evil chain that I broken, every evil chain that I broke, they are all broken forever. In the name of Jesus, chains of rejection, chains of failure at the edge of breakthrough. Chains of failure at the edge of breakthrough. Chains of failure at the edge of a miracle. Chains of giving up at the edge of a miracle. Yes, chains of discouragements. They are all broken into pieces by the blood of Jesus. Say, evil covenants that were working against my life for rejection, for pollution, for contamination, for defilements, they are all destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Evil family covenants that were marking me for disaster, marking me for rejection, for dejection, for backwardness, for demotion, for retardation, they are all nullified by the blood of Jesus. They are all nullified by the blood of Jesus. Say, every curse that was pronounced against my life to cause rejection, to cause retardation, to cause pollutions, to cause contamination in my life, they are all nullified by the blood of Jesus. Say, family curses that were causing evil odor in my life, you are nullified forever by the blood of Jesus. Say, parental curses that were causing evil odor in my life, you are nullified now forever by the blood of Jesus. say generational curses that were causing evil odor in my spirit, in my soul, in my body. You are all nullified now by the blood of Jesus. Say evil pronouncements and satanic announcements that were made against my life to cause pollutions. They are all nullified by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say manifest now my divine attraction. Manifest now my divine attraction. Manifest now my divine beauty. Manifest now my divine beauty. Manifest now my divine handsomeness. Manifest now my divine progress. Manifest now my divine promotion. Manifest now my divine business. Manifest now my divine career. Manifest now my divine job. Manifest now my divine profession. Manifest now my divine education. Manifest now my divine connections. Manifest now my divine contacts. Manifest now my divine empowerment. Manifest now my divine favor. Manifest now my divine blessings. Manifest now my divine ideas. Manifest now. Manifest now. Manifest now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for the power in the blood of Jesus to cleanse us from any filth, to cleanse us from any contamination, to cleanse us from any pollutions, any defilements, that the blood of Jesus will never lose its power. Yes, it's working in our lives. And we thank you, Father, that it continues to work in our lives. We worship you. Thank you for the victory that we have through the blood of Jesus. And we thank you for the open doors, acceptance, and progress in our lives because of the power and the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.